When somebody's the president of the United States, the authority is total. And that's the way it's got to be.
Your authority is total.
It's total. It's total.
The president went out and said that he has the right, the authority to open up the country and tell the governors to open up things again.
You have a couple of bands of Democrat governors, but they will agree to it. They will agree to it. But the authority of the president of the United States having to do with the subject we're talking about is total.
Legal experts say he doesn't have that authority. After initially saying he was going to do it, he's now just sort of urging people to do what they want.
It's going to be up to the governors. We're going to work with them. We're going to help them. But it's going to be up to the governors.
One of the things that's been really interesting about the governors is you can kind of feel their eyes roll a little bit, right? So in the beginning, a lot of the governors were waiting for the president to act and say what the national guidelines would be, and he didn't do that. But now, fast forward a few weeks, what's happening is the president went out and said that he has the authority to open up the country, and the governors are saying, wait a minute, you wouldn't give us a national order, so how can you tell us what to do now?
The federal government does not have absolute power. So it's the exact opposite that the president said.
And I prayed we would be there based on their metrics. We're just not there yet.
Like most governors, I've acknowledged that the things that I've gotten to see is a sustained decrease in the number of positives.
While some of them are pushing back, they're not pushing back as hard as you might think. They've kind of learned during this crisis that to get something from this president, you often need to flatter him. And I know that sounds a little bit like a joke, but remember he said a couple weeks ago, I want the governors to appreciate me and appreciate what I'm doing. If they don't, I don't call them.
I say, Mike, don't call the governor of Washington. You're wasting your time with him. Don't call the woman in Michigan. Well, it doesn't make any difference what happens.
The governor of Washington?
No, you know what I say? If they don't treat you right, I don't call.
There were governors who took that seriously. Someone like the Florida governor, Ron DeSantis, who's very close to the president and talks to him, you know, pretty regularly, even without coronavirus. He really waited to act because he was waiting for the president to act. And when the president didn't, you know, close things down, then the governor finally had to act. But he was really criticized for being too late on that.
Well, I'm in contact with them, and basically, you know, I've said, are you guys recommending this? The task force has not recommended that to me. If they do, you know, obviously that would be something that would carry a lot of weight with me. You know, there's not really any more you can do in Southeast Florida. You just got to kind of stay the course at this point.
Then you're seeing governors like Gavin Newsom, who has the governor of California, who's really been at odds with the president for 3 years on everything like climate change and immigration. He's actually been complimentary of the president.
I do want to extend, just in broad strokes, appreciation for what I heard from the president as it relates to recognizing the differentiation that exists and persists in terms of conditions.
The president has the authority to do things that governors don't. He can deal with the north and south borders. He can deal with international travel, who can come into the country. Those are things that the governors can't do, but the governors can deal with their own schools. They can deal with their own businesses, what's essential, what's not essential. They can deal with medical facilities. You know, remember, the governors deal with emergencies like floods and hurricanes and tornadoes all the time. So they're sort of used to those emergency powers that let them close things, open things. The Constitution does not give the president right to overrule them in any way on those things. You know, there was some confusion in the beginning, where both the governors were looking at the president and the president was looking at the governors. Who's gonna make the decision on whether residents have to stay at home, whether businesses can be opened or closed? And the president really just issued non-binding guidelines. He had talked as if he wanted a hard start. You know, remember back when he said, oh, we'll be open by Easter back then?
I'd love to have it open by Easter.
Over time, he has really realized he's really looking at a phased-in approach, and I think that's partly because that's the guidance he's been given by his aides and by business people and other people he's consulted.
Our team of experts now agrees that we can begin the next front in our war, which we are calling opening up America again.
He threatened at the beginning of the week, and then he really backed off and said, well, I'm going to let them do whatever they want. I'm going to push them to open, but I'm not going to tell them what to do. He does that all the time.
If they need to remain closed, we will allow them to do that. And if they believe it is time to reopen, we will provide them the freedom and guidance to accomplish that task, and very, very quickly. depending on what they want to do.
He does it as sort of a negotiating tactic, and then kind of he looks really authoritative and he looks very forceful and aggressive. Then he gets a little bit for that, or maybe nothing for that, and then he kind of backs down. So it's really part of his MO, I think, that he threatens things like he did.